السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Happy day for all of us إن شاء الله. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. نحمده ونشكره ونستعيذ من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. نحمد الله كثيرا that we pray صلاة الصبح in his house and we ask him to accept it. And he will, inshallah, and put it in our hasanat and keep us under his own provisions and his protection for today and for every other day. Welcoming people coming from Al-Umrah, Brother Tawfiq, Brother Abdul Majid. Welcome back. Umrah maqboola, inshallah. Okay, I hope Allah will accept your supplication for yourself and for us also. And Ibrahim, Brother Ibrahim, for us, we hope for you shifa and ajil, inshallah. Welcome you guys. We're still talking about Ghazwat Badr, but we're coming to an end. Okay, now we have 70 people, prisoners of war. Okay, and let's see how Rasulullah and the Sahaba will deal with them. So all of those asra, all of those hostages were being taken to Al-Masjid al-Nabawi. And the people, men and women and everyone, went out to look who is still alive from their families, you know. And Sayyida Sauda bint Zam'a radiallahu anha, zawjat al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, actually went out also with them to look for him. For them, she's looking for her husband, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Okay, and they sat down, all of them now. Okay, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam start telling the people, his companion, hey, you folks, okay, we have 70 people of the best of Quraysh in our hands now. And you remember what they have been doing to us. You remember how they hated us, how they kicked us out, how they mistreated us. Okay. فَمَاذَا تَرَوْنَا نَفْعَلْ بِهِمْ. What do you think we're going to be doing with them? You tell me, okay? Tell me what we're going to be doing with them. See, Rasulullah still, he can decide exactly by himself, you know, what they're going to be doing. Okay, but he's actually, that's his nature. Asking the, you know, his companions to find out the best solution or the best opinion. So tell me, you folks, what we're going to be doing with them. At that time, there was nothing really in the Quran or, you know, in Quran to tell exactly how you're going to deal with the prisoners of war. There's nothing really was Sharia at that time, how to deal with the prisoners of war. So Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu stood up and he said, Abu Bakr is very soft-hearted, very nice, he's merciful, okay, like Rasulullah, they are really like each other. So he stood up, he said, Ya Rasulullah, those are our people, those are from our tribes, those are from our families, okay? And I see that we can take the ransom from them and we can set them free, right? And the ransom, okay, will benefit us because everybody is being taken as a hostage by somebody and he's gonna take that ransom, it's gonna help him money-wise. So we can do that, or if you really want to set them free without anything, it's actually, you do that, that's actually from your good manners. Either leave them or we just take them the ransom from them, which is going to be helping us and which is going to make us really good in front of the rest of Quraysh that we really set them free or took the ransom and we let them go out. So he preferred to take the ransom, okay, and or set them free. That's actually a merciful solution. Overpower. We're not going to do anything, we're not going to harm them, but we're just going to do that. Then ذن سيدنا عمر صلى الله عليه وسلم، عمر بن الخطاب، عمر بن الخطاب السويفت جاي، سترونج، لا 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 يلومه لومه متلائم. اوكي، هي وونتس تو جاست، هي دوزنت نو لو از لو. اوكي، هي سيد ستود اب اند سيد، يا رسول الله، I don't agree with what Abu Bakr said. Those people are the worst of the people. You remember how did they do to us, how they dealt with us. Okay, they قاتلوك, they أخرجوك, they ridiculed you, they mistreated you. Okay, we're gonna chop their heads. That's it. He's very swift. Okay. We'll do that so Allah will know that we really don't have anything good for those people in our hearts. We hate them forever. So that's the opinion of Umar ibn al-Khattab, al-Hasm, being swift, okay, and kill them. He said, we'll kill them no matter what, even if they are our close relatives. Let everybody from us look for the person from his family and kill him. Okay? Now, so the two opinions now, one mercy, one swift, one really killing them. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he listened to both of them and he left them, went to his home for a while and came back. And he said, Ya Abu Bakr, ana mislak ya Abu Bakr. Kamathali Ibrahim alayhi salam. He said, you are actually doing, or actually your opinion is the same like what Ibrahim alayhi salam. He said, Ibrahim said, فَمَنْ تَبَعَنِي فَإِنَّهُ مِنِّي وَمَنْ عَصَانِي فَإِنَّكَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. That's, you acted exactly like Prophet Ibrahim. He said, مَنْ تَبَعَنِي فَإِنَّهُ مِنِّي وَمَنْ عَصَانِي فَإِنَّكَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. This is Surah Ibrahim. Okay. What Sayyidina Ibrahim said, whoever follows me, then he is from me. إِنَّهُ مِنِّي مَنْ تَبَعَنِي, who's coming, same like me, mercy. Okay. Indeed, you are forgiving and the most merciful. Okay. And if you don't, then you are the most merciful and you are the most forgiving. Then he looked at Umar ibn al-Khattab. See, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he talks to anybody, he makes that body just feeling that he is the most important person for him. He can talk to 100 people and everybody will feel that he is, he really means that he is the most favorable person to him. That's eloquence and that's politeness and this is the mercy of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Okay. Then he stood up and he said, أما أنت يا عمر فأنا مثلك. أنا مثلك. كمثل نوح عليه السلام. Prophet Noah. Okay. What Prophet Noah said. Okay. He said, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وقال نوح ربي لا تذر على الأرض من الكافرين ديارا إنك إن تذرهم يضلوا عبادك ولا يلدوا إلا فاجرا كفارا. That's a surah Nuh again, verse 26 and 27. So he said, you acted exactly like Prophet Nuh did. Okay. So he said, Nuh said, my Lord, don't leave on earth homes of the disbelievers. Indeed, if you leave them, they will mislead your servants and they will not give birth except the immoral, fajiran, and disbelievers. So I'm agreeing with you. I'm agreeing with you. Okay. And he made the resemblance of Abu Bakr and Umar radiallahu anhu, resemblance with Sayyidina Ibrahim and Sayyidina Nuh, the two people of Ulil Azm. Okay. So everybody is happy now. ثم قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، أنا I am with I lean to the opinion of Abu Bakr. Okay, we'll just take the fida from them, the ransom from them. It's gonna help us. We are poor, okay, and any money you can get from those guys, actually, it's better for us to sustain our life, and it will make us look good in front of the Quraysh. Maybe Allah will guide them, and Allah will know how we treated them very nicely, and probably they will adopt Islam. That's actually the manners, and that's the akhlaq, and that's the mercy of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he said, now we're going to take the ransom. The ransom, how much? It depends on the condition, the financial condition of the person, of the hostage. The rich one, we're going to take 4,000 dirham, silver. The poor one will take $1,000. 1,000 dirham, okay? Dollars was gonna be printed at the time. We'll take 1,000, 4,000 and 1,000, depending on the condition, okay? And if somebody doesn't have anything, just let him go and teach 10 of those people, then teach them how to write and read. And if he doesn't know, he is free. What a nice thing, I mean, beautiful, beautiful way of treating the hostages. So you see, if he doesn't have anything, if anybody is really poor enough, can't even pay the ransom, he can't even, you know, teach the 10 of the Muslims how to read and write, okay, go free. So here you see Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was one of the, was the first who actually called for mahw al-ummiyah, for removing or eliminating illiteracy, calling for learning how to read and how to write. Okay. Anyway, let's talk about one person only today, how he dealt with him. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he saw in Al-Asra, his uncle, Al-Abbas. Al-Abbas was fighting with the Mushrikeen. Actually, he saw that, I think in a dream, or he felt that Al-Abbas is there. Al-Abbas, radiallahu anhu, okay, he was forced to go out with the Mushrikeen, although he was Muslim. But he didn't declare that, he kept it, because he doesn't want to create any problems with Quraysh. So he was forced to go out with them, okay? And he was really very helpful to Muslims. Although he was hiding his Islam, he was very helpful. He used to report to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about how Quraysh is talking about him, how they are plotting against him. So he used to tell him continuously, you know, what is the condition of Quraysh and what are they planning to do to him. So he's always providing him with information about Quraysh. And many times Al-Abbas radiallahu anhu, okay, he asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to go and migrate also to go Al-Madina. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, no ya Abbas, okay, no. Okay, your place in Mecca is much better for you. I want you to migrate, to be the last one to migrate. As'alullah an takun akhir man hajar, same way like me, akhir man khatima bi an-nubuwa, the same like I am the last who is a prophet. Okay, so stay in Mecca, that's much better for you. Okay, and and he actually, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was saying in the before the battle, when the battle was about to start, he said, "Man laqiya al-Abbas fala yaqtuluhu." So he actually he knows he knows that he is actually Muslim, okay, and he was forced to go out. من أقل من 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 لقي العباس فلا فلا يقتل العباس. Actually not only his uncle, he's also عديل. He's actually he's like brother in law. So زوجة الرسول وزوجة العباس are sisters, okay. ميمونة زوجة الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم رضي الله عنه وزوجة الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم and her sister لبابة her sister أم الفضل you remember زوجة العباس those are sisters so they are أصهار رسول and العباس are أصهار and عم and ابن أخ okay anyway and Remember, Umm al-Fadl, you remember Umm al-Fadl, we talked about it maybe like few weeks ago, Umm al-Fadl, when Abu Lahab, Allah la yarda anhu, okay, Abu Lahab, when he went to her to create an amnesty, okay, and he said, Ya Umm al-Fadl, he doesn't know that Abbas is actually Muslim, Ya Umm al-Fadl, oh, they took your husband as a hostage in Badr. She wants to initiate her, you know, hate against Muslim. So she told him, what did you say? He said, come here close, tell me. So he came to her and she took the wood, piece of wood and just hit him and he shagged Ra'as. You remember that? We told about that before, okay? Al-Abbas, radiallahu anhu, actually, he was born before Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by 2 or 3 years. So he's in age, he's older than Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But because he's so polite, and he's so rich also, Abbas is so rich, okay? He's so polite, when they ask him, people when they ask him, who is older, you or Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? See that, now the polite answer. He is older in age-wise, 2 or 3 years, he says, أَنَا أَسَنُّ مِنْهُ I am. Aging wise, I am older than him, but he's bigger than me. You don't say an akbar min Rasulullah, no matter what. Rasulullah is the top. But you want to talk about age, yeah, and I am a sinman, or I am aqallu sinnan min. You can say that. Okay. He, as I said, he declared the Islam and he migrated just before Fath Makkah. So probably in the 12th year of the Ba'tha, that's actually when he migrated to Al-Madina. And he attended Fath Makkah, of course, and he attended the Battle of Hunayn. And he was always the guy who was urging the people during the Battle of Hunayn to go ahead, go forward, okay, and victory, inshallah, will be written for you. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to love him very much. And he says, من آذى العباس فقد آذاني فإنه عم فإنما عم الرجل صفو أبي. He says, always talking about العباس radiallahu anhu, he said, whoever hurt him, whoever mistreated him, is as if he is really hurt me and mistreated me. فإنه مني وأنا منه. Okay? Anyway, it's enough today. Right. Allah khalid. Any questions, any additions, any corrections? Inshallah, next week, we're going to be talking about some of the prisoners of war, okay, and how Rasulullah dealt with them. Beautiful stories. Two beautiful stories among what I'm going to be mentioning. Suhail ibn Amr. Okay. And Abu al-As ibn Rabi'ah, Zawj, Sayyida Zainab bint Rasulullah. Beautiful stories, really beautiful stories. And we see how Rasulullah dealt with them and how they dealt with Rasulullah and how he was kind, you know. And I'm sure you're going to enjoy it, inshallah. Okay. Allahumma inni da'an fa'am. اللهم يا منزل الكتاب يا سريع الحساب يا هازم الأحزاب زلزل الأرض تحت أقدام الصهاينة المغتصبين يا عزيز يا كريم اللهم عليك بهم، أرسل عليهم جند من عندك ومن فوقهم ومن تحتهم ومن أيمانهم وشمائلهم، خذهم أخذ عزيز مقتدر. اللهم لا تعذبنا بمرض ولا تشقينا بولد ولا تسلط علينا أحد، ونجنا من شر النفاثات في العقد وشر حاسد إذا حسد. اللهم دبر أمورنا وأصلح أحوالنا، واجعل لنا من كل هم فرجا، ومن كل ضيق مخرجا، ومن كل داء دواء، ومن كل مرض شفاء، ومن كل بلاء عافية. وارحم موتانا، واشفي مرضانا، وعافي مبتلانا يا أرحم الراحمين. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Thank you very much.